Pastor Joe came back home to 340 Cherry Street, the neighborhood that has been his life's blood, the only place he's ever felt a part of. Through the hard work of the Abounding Grace staff, the church has experienced a steady growth. For over 5 years, they've been located right in the middle of the East Village.
This is a great location. This building that we're meeting in reality, it is a lighthouse for the Lower East Side of Manhattan. It is a beacon of light telling the Lower East Side of Manhattan, the East Village, and the West Village that Jesus Christ is the answer to New York.
The Lord also blessed him with his current wife, Denise. She shares his passion for ministry and is a deacon at the church. She is also one of the teachers of the Firm Foundation class. As for Joshua, no one can deny he's his father's son. His love of God is a testament to the life his father gave him. And Alana is happily married and living in Virginia. Pastor Joe even performed her wedding. His beloved mother moved to Tampa, Florida. He visits her every chance he gets. While her health has declined in recent years, her eyes light up every time she sees her little Joey. The devotion between them has been the most enduring. And Pastor Joe's a grandfather now, but that hasn't slowed him down. He performs weddings, baptisms, and still travels around the country. He recently returned from a missions trip to Cuba and appeared on Canadian television. He has also written 2 books and recorded several CDs. When he's back home, most mornings he can be found at Jackson Park where he played as a child, feeding the birds and offering counseling to the many people that call on him. Or you can just catch him at his favorite restaurant, Castillo's. Like Pastor Joe always says, I sleep in the Bronx, but I live on the Lower East Side. One thing's for sure, just ask him and he'll tell you what his life's mission has been.
My life's goal is to promote a message of hope, that there is hope in Jesus Christ, that there is eternal life in Jesus Christ, that there is peace in Jesus Christ, that there is joy unspeakable and full of glory in the name of Jesus.
Men shall love each other. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believes in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life. Right now, as you're sitting, or possibly even standing, you've messed up your life. You've sinned. You're far from God. But I want you to understand that he's near to the one who's willing to call on his name. I'm asking you right where you are to ask Jesus Christ to come into your heart. He'll forgive you of your sins, of everything that you've ever done in your past, and he will give you a brand new beginning. You can't buy that. It's free, and it's a free gift for you. So right where you are, would you repeat this simple little prayer? And the Bible says that if you confess with your mouth, and if you believe it in your heart, that you're going to be saved. Come on, repeat after me. Dear God, I come to you in the name of Jesus. I admit that I'm a sinner. I need you to be my Savior. Come into my heart. Forgive me of my past. Give me a brand new beginning. I believe that you died on the cross to forgive me of my sins, and that you have promised me a home in heaven. So right now, according to your word, I receive you as my Lord and as my Savior. And I believe that my past is forgiven and my future is in your hands. I'm here to tell you right now, young man, young lady, that the decision that you've made in receiving Christ as your Lord and your Savior, now you are promised a future as you seek the Lord. He's pulled you out of a place that you have been a prisoner for so long, and now he has set you free. Walk in your freedom. Square your shoulders and hold your head up high and walk forward, because if God is for you and if he goes before you, then who can be against you? And know that from this day on, your name has been written in the Lamb's Book of Life. Search the scriptures, pray every day, and seek God's face. Get to church and pursue your walk with the Lord. Know that he loves you. And no matter what you've ever done, we're so grateful and thankful that he is a God of new beginnings.